Now let's look at a net logo version of the logistic map. This is on the course materials page. And what this is going to do is do exactly what I was doing in the previous subunit, which is showing the parabola of the logistic map and showing how the trajectory of points moves along it over time. Here I can set R with this slider, and I can set the initial value for x, x0. So R is 2, x0 is 0.2. Here's the logistic map, and I click Setup, and it draws my parabola. And here you can see I'm plotting x sub t versus x sub t plus 1. We start out, x sub t is 0.2, x sub t plus 1 is 0.32, and every time I click go, it advances the system by one time step. Here we plotted x of t is 0.32, x of t plus 1 is 0.4352, and the point moved. So you see 0.32 on the x-axis here and 0.4352 on the y-axis. Go again. And I go again. And you can see the whole thing iterating until it's reached a fixed point attractor of 0.5. And you can see the plot of x sub t versus time right here. So these are two different ways of visualizing the trajectory of the map. Now we can also see that if we change x0, let's make x0 now all the way up to 0.9, for example. Well, 0.90285, close enough. I'll do setup. Okay, same parabola, but now x0 starts at a different point. So here's 0.9029, and the corresponding next time step is 0.1754. So you can see that's this blue point. And we go, and we go again, and you can see that the system goes back to the point 0.5, 0.5, and stays there. Same thing if we change x0 all the way down to, let's say, some really small value here, 0.01143. So we set up. So it's very close to zero down here at the bottom. And go. If I click go repeatedly, again, the system ends up at the value of 0.5 and stays there. So this is 0.5 here is a fixed point attractor for the system. No matter where the system starts, it always ends up at the value of the attractor. Now we can vary our value of R to see how the growth rate, R, changes as it moves up. So I'm going to change it here to, it's a little bit hard to change precisely, 2.50. I should point out another way to change this, if you want it to have a precise value, is to right click on it, edit, and I can give its exact value here. So I just type that in. Okay, so now what happens? Set up. Well, now this time the parabola is higher, and that's because I changed the value of R. And what changing the value of R does is it changes the height of this parabola. Okay, so now let's say I start out with x0. Here I'm going to edit it, and I'm going to change this value to 0.2. Okay, and do setup again. Okay, now 0.2 and 0.4. Okay, and we go, and we see very quickly the system gets to 0.6. That was the quiz from the last subunit. And if I change the x0 again, let's make it 0.9 something, do setup, let's see what happens. Again, the system converges on 0.6, but it does it by a different trajectory. It gets there in a different way. It takes a little longer this time. And again, if I move this all the way down to something very low here. Set up. Okay, now this is close to zero. I do go. Again, gradually gets to 0.6. So 0.6 is the fixed point attractor for this system with a different value of R. So you can see that the value of R is really what determines the ultimate dynamics of the system. And when we talk about the ultimate dynamics, we talk about what kind of attractor, if any, the system settles down into after some number of time steps. So this system has, we say, fixed point attractor dynamics, where the fixed point is 0.6. Okay, let's try this another time. Let's set this R to 2.8. I'll set X again to 0.2. Okay, set up. The parabola is higher again. And let's see what happens. Well, this time, you can see the little dot bouncing back and forth. It takes a long time for it to settle down. And finally, it settled down to this point, 6429. Remember, these are approximations because x sub t is a real number. And it's possible that there's more decimal places out there that we're cutting off by rounding to a certain number of decimal places. So it's possible that it could still be oscillating more if we looked at more decimal places. But eventually, it does settle down into a fixed point. But it takes a longer time. That's one of the effects of raising this R, is the time it takes to settle down to a fixed point. One thing to note about NetLogo is, again, I can go into one of these output boxes and you can set the number of decimal places you want to see. And the maximum it allows you is 17.